Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to convert a clean black and white image to a vector in Adobe Illustrator. It's a really simple process, but only if you have a really large, clean black and white image. If you have something small and blurry, you're going to have to really tweak your settings to get a good result. And I actually have another video that shows that process, and it's right up here at the top of your screen. But I would try this way first to see if it'll work, and if not, then try the other way. Now you might be wondering, what is that black eye she has? And long story short, volleyball. If you play sports long enough, you're eventually going to end up with injuries like this, and it's no big deal. But anyway, I just wanted to address it. All right, let's get started. Okay, so I have a simple black and white coffee cup that I drew in Procreate and exported as a JPEG. Now, when I drew this in Procreate, I had a really huge canvas. I think it was 2048 by 2048 from here to here. So obviously this is a little smaller, but either way, it's pretty big. That is a good thing when we're trying to use image trace in Illustrator. Okay, so I'm just going to take this and pull it on my Adobe Illustrator icon. You can also go to File, Place, and bring it in that way. Now I'm going to hit Command Y or Control Y. That will show us whether it has vector pieces in it or not. And as you can see, it's just a big white box. I'll hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. Okay, now first we need to select it. So click on the image itself. You can see the little blue box with your handles on it. And then come up here to the top to Image Trace. Now, if you're not seeing this bar, go to Window, Control right here. And I'm gonna click Image Trace. So right now we're seeing the potential image trace result. It looks very clean, looks good. So now we'll expand right up here. Now if I hit Command Y or Control Y, I can see all of the vector pieces, which is a good thing. But we need to get rid of this white. So I'm gonna hit Y on my keyboard, and that'll give me the magic wand tool. I'll just click out here on the white. You'll see it come in as the color right here, and I'll hit delete. Now we have all the pieces that are left, which are the black pieces. Now if we hit E, which is your free transform tool, or A, which is your direct select, you can see all those little anchor points that make up your image. Now we can resize this by getting on our selection tool and just holding shift and making it bigger or smaller. We can rotate by getting right outside that handle until we get the rotate icon and rotate it like that. I'm going to undo with Command Z or Control Z. And of course you can make other modifications. I could use my group selection to go in here and draw a box around my text and move that around if I wanted to, or delete it. It's a full vector right now, so we can do anything we want. Now to save this, you'll want to save as an AI document. So I'll hit Shift Command S or Shift Control S to do Save As. It's also under File. And I'm going to save this as coffeecup.ai. And the format down here will be Adobe Illustrator, and that's what you want. So we'll save that. Now, if you're wanting to save this for cutting machines, you can also save as SVG, and the process is the same. So we'll come up here to File, Save As, and then down here, we'll choose SVG, the very bottom one, and that will make it an SVG file. And we'll say okay. Now, if you wanted to save for DXF, that is also a vector format. Go ahead and go to File, Export, and then Export As, and here you can change it to DXF, which is Autodesk Real DWG. So we'll go ahead and do that and say okay. So those are a few different ways you can save your file. I would always keep your .ai file because it does work slightly differently from an SVG or DXF file. So keep that file, but then save your variations too. And that's it. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.